Hello friends and welcome to our video. Now before we move ahead, it is very important topic to know in Salesforce is collections. Now these are not Salesforce collections, these are simple collections which we have in Java and other programming as well. So primarily we have three type of collections. One is list, one is set, and one is map. And they have got their own characteristics, they have got their own benefits, pros and cons. So we will see what to use when and what are they. So I will go to, let's say, creating a new Apex class. Now the first collection is a list. Now list could be a list of a primitive data type or S objects, like a list of string or list of account or list of any custom object. Okay, so what is a list? A list is basically a collection of data. It can have duplicate records, but those are all sequential. Okay, so we can have, let's say I have a list of account ACC list. So by using, because it is a sequential data, it has got indexing for each and every value. So we can have ACC list 0, that would be having some value. Okay, then ACC list 1 will be holding another value, ACC list 2. And list is very important because all the SQL queries, the return type of all SQL queries is a list. Okay, and return type of all SOSL query is a list of list. Okay, so return type of all SQL query is a list of S objects, and return type of all SOSL query is a list of S objects. Okay, now let's say you write a SQL query. Let's say you write list contact con list equals to select ID, comma, last name, order by last name. Okay, so you can have these type of clause in your SQL queries, and if you want ascending, you can have ASC. Okay, so now this con list will actually have those names in order. So con list zero will be having the first name starting with A, con one will be having next name as per the dictionary. Okay, so if I need to access, let's say first contact will be equals to con list 0. Okay, so second will be con list 1, third will be con list 2. So in that case, and what would be last contact? Would be last contact could be simply last contact equals to con list. Okay, and what will be the value? So we can simply have con list dot size minus 1, because you see it is starting from 0. So this size minus 1 will be the actual last location, because it starts from 0, not from 1. Had the list been starting from 1, then we could have simply con list dot size. Okay, because it starts from 0, so we need to subtract 1 from the last position, then we can get last contact. So in this way, we can have list, we can play with the list, we can add value to the list. Like if we have a list of string, str list. So we can use list methods like add. So we can add this value to list, then again str list dot add. So the first one will go at 0th position, second one will go at 1st position. So if we will try to access, so we will get this back. Okay, if we try to access 1, we will get this back. So in this way we can play with our list as well. Now then next is set. So what is a set? Set is nothing but, set are also similar to list, it's just that they have unique record and they do not have any order. Primarily in Salesforce, we will create set of IDs at several places. to store unique IDs. So wherever you want to have unique records, you use set. And it is an unordered collection. You do not have that indexing thing. Okay? In sets. So you cannot access values from set by using the indexing which we did in list. You can but run a for loop on set and you can access values from set. So let's say we want to set define a set of string. Str set, we can name it anything, equals to new set, and either you can populate the values here itself or you can just define a set here, and later on when you have your collection you can add that to set. So simply you can have something like A comma B comma C. Okay, so we have defined a set containing three values here. Okay, and with a semicolon. Or if you simply you can declare a set, let's say you declare a set of an integer, str set equals to new set of integer, okay, and then later on you can add str set dot add 1, okay, str set dot add 25, whatever it is. Or you can have a set of, let's say, ID with respect to Salesforce, and let's say you're writing this in a trigger. So for account ACC colon trigger dot new, okay, and you can add here str set dot add acc dot id. So a lot of times these helps in minimizing your code. It improves your performance. How? That later on, let's say in your trigger you want to query contacts, so it could be select id comma name comma account id. But you don't want to go ahead and query your whole Salesforce org. You could have lakhs and millions of records. You want to limit your query. You want to make it optimized. So where here you can use this set where account ID in str set. Okay. So because you want to work with a particular set of records at a time. So in this way you can create a set. You can add the ID into that set. And you can then or if it was written on a contact. So acc dot account id, so that will have populated the set with the account IDs of the contact, the lookup field on contact which we have. Okay, so, and then we have maps. Maps are very powerful. People get confused a lot with this, but they are very easy to understand. They actually have two values, a key and the value. Okay, so these are mapped with each other. So mapping of key with values, that is why we call it as map. And you need to go through Salesforce documentation because they have all got their own methods, add, remove and all those kind of methods. Like in map, we have put, we have get. So map, and let's say I want to create a map of string. So string would be key, then string would be values. Okay, so actually both the values of a string type, one is key, one is value. And how we can use this, let's say I create a map by populating right here. I name it new map equals to new map string, and I want to populate the values here itself. So I need to specify a key, I need to specify value. Let's say A is the key and then B is the value. See, key to value mapping. Then again we want to add one more value. Let's say C is the key and D is the value. So if you access the key of the map, you will get value back. Okay, and close here, make it here. Let's say I create a map. If I go ahead and get method out of map, I will give new map dot get C. So if I will give C, it will actually return D. because I will specify the key and it will return the value of that key. So that is why map is used. Or if you want to iterate over the keys, we have map.keyset. If you want to add these values to another set of integers, let's say if you want to break this map into key and value separately, you want to get the key out of this, you can simply, let's say you want to create a set of integers equals to new map, the name of the map dot key set. So it will return all the key values of this map. Okay. Now map is a collection. It will have multiple keys and multiple values. Similarly, let's say you create a map with key of integer type and value of string type. Okay. I hope you are able to understand what I am trying to explain here. No issues if in the beginning you find it difficult, but as you will use it in your codes, you will find it much easier. Okay. Now, in list and set, what we were using add method. But in map, we use put method. So, new map dot put. We need to specify a key and we need to specify a value. So, let's say key will be of integer type. Let's say 1. And value will be of string type. Let's say I will say first value. Similarly, you can put another value, you can put another value, or even you can use a for loop and add values directly to this. So, 2, second value. Okay. Now we have added two values. Now, if I go ahead and get the value at position 2, so I will need to specify the second key. So, and if I want to get the value, I can simply have string and any name of the variable, let's say value equals to new map dot get 2. So what I'm giving, I'm specifying the key, and what it will return? It will return this thing, the value of that key. Okay, understood? So in map, you actually specify the key and you get the value. So if you're adding IDs here, you specify ID, you get the corresponding record. ID, comma, or S object if you're creating a map. So specify ID and you get the S object back. So map in this way, we can use map also. Okay. What else? I think that was all for the video. Then take care. Bye-bye. All the best.